Josie, thank you so much. Developing this morning, heavy rain overnight closes a portion of 169 between St. Peter and Mankato.
Yeah, now the water already has logged the area. It's dumped with more rain overnight, as we mentioned. It's causing a lot of problems there. Five Eyewitness News reporter Katherine Johnson is live in Mankato this morning with a look. You got there early when it was still dark out. The sun is starting to come out, and you're starting to see some of the problems.
Yeah, Megan, and it took us a little longer to get here, too, because southbound 169 was closed right around 4 o'clock this morning for a while due to mudslides. They want to stop cars from potential hydroplanes. And speaking of cars, here we are underneath 169, and we're sort of on a bike path here, but this is the Minnesota River swelling. And we just watched a van just plow right on through this. And if you look down, you can see how deep this water is. I'm not going any deeper because I will get flooded out, and I don't want to spend the rest of the day with wet socks. But it gives you an idea of this standing water. When you're looking at it, you don't really know how deep it is, but you can see this is dangerous. A car can float in just 4 inches of water. And according to the National Weather Service, Mankato almost got 4 inches of water just from midnight last night, and it's still sprinkling here a little bit. Those totals are still climbing. Now, the standing water here in Mankato, it comes and goes. Crews are having to move around a lot to maintain where that water is and try to move it, get the roads under control. But as soon as the river swells, the storm drains also take over and the water goes away. So crews are having a tough time figuring out where exactly they need to go to keep the water levels down. Now, unfortunately, in some parts of the city, the water has taken over basements, and it's making it just too tough for some drivers to get through.
A lot of standing water on the roadways. I actually pulled over here at the gas station. It was pretty rough.
We need the rain, but not this much.
So I mentioned it takes 4 inches of water to float a car. There's well over 4 inches of water on the road here where we're standing. And even less than that, 2 inches, your car can hydroplane right off into the ditch. So take it slow. Be careful when these roads are closed. That's serious. You don't want to go around those cones or any of those MnDOT trucks. They're trying to keep you safe and take care of you. We'll have another update in the next half hour. For now, live in Mankato, Katherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Katherine. Chopper 5 was there as we tracked the flooding in Laverne near the very southwest corner of the state. The Rock River has spilled over its banks. It's flooded a baseball field and the buildings surrounding it, as you see there. And this just south of the Minnesota border in Rock Rapids, Iowa. Look at that. A number of homes surrounded by water. People there are frantically sandbagging, doing whatever they can. The ABC station in Sioux Falls reports part of the north side of the town has been evacuated. Up north, flooding also continues to impact the North Woods. Yesterday, Governor Mark Dayton made a trip to the Canadian border to survey the damage of floodwaters in International Falls. Volunteers have filled, get this, over 100,000 sandbags to help save homes.
Make sure you stay with us here at 5 Eyewitness News. We will continue to follow this severe weather. You can always get the latest online as well. Just go to our website, kstp.com.